A national discount fashion retailer had a strategy of opening up stores with a specific income and population criteria in strip malls. Here we have two of those locations pulled up in ArcGIS, along with a 3-mile demographic profile for each one. As you can see, the demographics are very similar, yet the sales are nearly double in the second location. So why did these two stores perform so differently? Using a correlation analysis, we found a strong relationship between the presence of Smart Chic and Trend Trackers with total store sales across the portfolio. So let's take a look at these two segments. So here we have Smart Chic. This is people talking about discount brands, fashion, and vintage clothing. And then we also have Trend Trackers, and this one's about keeping up with the latest fashion trends, and you can see topics around brands of clothes and just a fast-paced lifestyle in general. So let's take a look at Smart Chic mapped over the underperforming location first. As you can see, about half of this area scores fairly low. We've got a 38 here, which means that this block group scores in the 38th percentile for all block groups in the US. Now, if we look at the high-performing location, you can see that this is completely surrounded by high-scoring areas. We've got an 82, a 95, another 95, and a 96. So this is a very high-scoring area for Smart Chic, which fits for this brand. All right, let's take this insight and apply it to choosing between three prospective locations. So let's map up Smart Chic again. And we can see that location 3, which is Westchester Shopping Center, has the closest overall match to this segment, indicating that this would probably be the best location for this retailer. And once we have chosen our site, we can then leverage this data further by geo-targeting ad campaigns to these high-scoring areas you see in dark red to further drive traffic and ultimately revenue for this new store location when it opens.